Okay guys, Flame here, and today, before the video starts, just want to say, this is the end. The part 4 is going to be the end of the series. After this episode, we will have covered all the characters. So yeah, if you have any ideas for a series similar to this one, if you want to see more content similar to this, leave it down in the comments below. I'll try to think of something, but if there's something in particular you want that's similar to this kind of style of video, put it into the comments and I'll read them all. And also, since this is the finale, you know, there's not another one coming after this, so it's not like we're setting a light goal to hit that. So let's just get 500 on this video just because it's the finale. If we don't, I'm not tripping because there's not going to be a part 5 anyways. And let's get right into the video. With Gilgamesh, laddering is super safe because if you stand still, they're just gonna track. So even if he was blocking, he's just gonna keep blocking them, and eventually that block break hit is either gonna hit or it's not. But like, the hits are guaranteed to hit him, so like, you're at least guaranteed 4 damage on the block break hit. See, like, he's getting hit. Like, you can't escape his M1s if you stand still with Gilgamesh. Once they start hitting, they're never gonna stop. So, like, laddering is super safe with him. Because even if they block the hits, they're just gonna keep getting hit until they get block broken, or that last hit's gonna hit, and that's 4 damage. You can down slam with Pinpoint to make it a combo extender. You can also down slam with Exterminate to make it a combo extender. And when you put all those combo extenders together, you get this. You can down slam into Chica's secondary balloon inflate. The downside to laddering with Chica's secondary balloon inflate though is, yeah, it's a true combo, but it takes very precise timing, and a lot of the time you'll get blocked because it's very hard timing, so you can also do that with her balloon. The hitbox of the normal balloon is super big, so it's either going to hit them or block break them. The only way they can get out of that combo is if they have hyper armor move that they use, like a hyper armor barrage, like Panther combo for example. That could have got out of that combo, but for the most part that works. And it's more safe than the secondary balloon inflate because it doesn't require timing. You can ladder with Chica's volleyball. And when you put all this stuff together, you can do stuff like this. For Chica's Awakening, use Love Detective right before Newspaper Barrage so it hits. With Giorno, if you are holding space and literally clicking at the speed of light, like you have to break your mouse click speed, you can sometimes, it doesn't happen all the time, but some of the times, after your barrage ends, you'll actually up tilt straight up and then you can just keep comboing. Okay, tips for Goku Black. First off, if you use continuous energy bullets right as you're about to pass by them with instant transmission, it will usually hit because the tracking is so stupid. The tracking is crazy. As you can see, I'm getting hits. Look how much health I did. He wasn't on my screen, bro. The tracking is so nuts. Second tip for Goku Black, make sure you always have Kamehameha off cooldown when you use Black Powerball so they can't block break themselves to avoid taking damage. Because if they're like way over there, for example, and they think they can just block break themselves because it will be less damage, make sure you have Kamehameha so you can do the extra damage. In Goku Black's Awakening, instant transmission is now an evasive, so you can do this. Literally just completely hijack somebody's combo. Just, it's literally stand defense basically. It's some of the best moving iframes in the game. That's how base Goku Black's instant transmission used to be, so yeah, but that got nerfed. second tip of Goku Black's Awakening, you can kind of combo extend with Twin Spirit Bomb if you down slam into it. It'll be a down tilt, or you can do that. That's what I like to do. You can down tilt into God Slicer, or you can down tilt into more M1s, but that's blockable. So down tilt into God Slicer after you down slam with Twin Spirit Bomb is a true combo. Bruh, the tips I have for him, everybody probably knows that the character is very straightforward and doesn't take that much thought. So like, first off, Infinity's not like other counters. Startup, there is no startup. Like, it's not gonna get canceled. You can, it's instant. So if you see something, no matter how close it is to you, as long as it hasn't hit you yet, you can use Infinity and it will work. Second tip, to make backhand guaranteed, never get block broken. Like, you just attack cancel on the fourth hit, attack cancel on the fourth with backhand, and it will always hit. You can ladder with collapsing blue. Basically, you just double tap three when you go up, and yeah. And now let's go into his awakening. Basically, the only things that people might not know, but all of you probably already know it, is Unlimited Void makes collapsing blue guard break, makes stronger backhand teleport, and it also makes hollow purple track. Okay, everybody knows Grimmjow's one-shot combo, just ladder with the Cero and pair the combo. We're not going over that. The one tip I do have for his base though is don't use Hero like before you engage. Like, don't pop it like right here and then go fight. Only pop it if you're in a combo, so you can mitigate all the damage from the combo. Don't pop it beforehand so it runs out once you start getting hit and then you just take all the damage. In Grimmjow's Awakening, you can ladder with his Panther Claw. You can make Engine Dash a combo extender if you ladder with it. That may have not looked like a ladder, but if you don't hold space the whole time, you'll get blocked as soon as Engine Dash goes off. You have to ladder with it. Even though it didn't look like it, I actually was laddering. If you do a down slam and then wait and do down kick, you can actually get 5 hits before down kick instead of the usual 4. Because usually you'll just do 4 hits down kick, but if you down slam first, you'll get 5. You can ladder with Bicycle Kick. And Jet Kick can be canceled early. It just does less damage when you do that. In PTS Luffy's base, you can down slam attack cancel with Bazooka to get a guaranteed hit. Also, in PTS Luffy's base, Gatling has more range than a sword or punches, so if somebody's in range and trying to M1 you and barely missing, just catch them with Gatling. A lot of people counter his awakening by just not holding F, so the Jet Bazooka flings them so they don't get guard broken, so they don't get hit by Jet Gatling. So if people are doing this, literally just use Jet Bazooka and Jet Pistol, because that's the most damage you're gonna do the entire awakening if they're just running away, letting Jet Bazooka hit them. Basically, what I'm saying is don't use Jet Pistol before Jet Bazooka, because that might bite you in the butt and Jet Pistol will just never hit. Also, in PTS Luffy's awakening, you can ladder with Jet Pistol. Okay, my tips for PTS Sasuke is, if you down slam attack cancel with Chidori, it makes it a lot more likely that it will hit, and then you can just one-shot the enemy after that. Also, in his awakening, you can actually ladder with Fuma Shuriken. You just delay it a little bit to make sure that it hits. Rukia's flash dodge is just like Aizen's, where you can start it to get out a combo and then quickly hijack the combo if you just cancel it fast. Rukia can also do the trick Byakuya can do, where you attack cancel with the move at the same time as you guard break, and you do that with her one for extra damage. See? And now it's still guard broken, and now I can do my entire combo with just extra damage. almost one shots. Narukia's Awakening, you can attack cancel on the fourth hit to make sure her one hits. And you can down slam with her four to make sure that hits. For Saitama, I only have like two tips, or maybe three. It's only because this is another, but they're not like super like crazy tips. Like, you probably know them. Like, there's not that much about this character. First off, when you're using Justice Tackle, spam machine punches afterwards, because machine punches will land a lot more than M1s. M1s will usually get blocked after Justice Tackle. Second tip for Saitama is in his mode. After Image is actually very strong on him, because usually with characters with After Image, you'll do one M1 and then the rest will miss because of like a delay. But Saitama doesn't have that. So the second you see them double jump or do something that gets them standing still, just quickly go up and then they get one shot. So yeah. The thing is though, you just have to wait, like they can't, if they're dashing forward mid you After Image, it might not work, but what the tip is basically, After Image in Saitama's Awakening is super consistent to get full combos, not just one strike. First tip with Todoroki, you can ladder with Ice Path. Bruh. See? Second thing for Todoroki, his giant ice wall in his awakening is blockable, so always do the flames first. And also, same thing with my tip on Byakuya, where like you attack cancel the last hit of your M1 with a move. You can do that with Todoroki. So you can do that with Flash Freeze Heat Wave, and then you just get over there. See? This works with actually majority of the beams in the game. So this tip applies to basically any character with a beam. But if you attack cancel the beam on the fourth hit, you actually don't need to ladder, making it so base Vegeta can one shot without going off the ground, and a lot of other beam characters can too. Another tip for Vegeta is, if they're just turtling and dodging explosive wave and stuff, do 5 hits and then go like that, because they'll want to unblock to get away from the 5th hit, but you can just rush. That also is viable for other Dragon Ball characters. In Vegeta's Awakening, same thing with Saitama's, wait till they're in an animation or right after they double jump, or just if they're standing still or something, as long as they're not dashing, because like if you M1 right as you do After Image, you can actually get the entire combo off and just one shot them. But yeah, that you just gotta right when you press After Image M1, like even before you teleport, so right when you start teleporting, you can do an entire combo without it just being a singular M1. Because that's usually what happens when you After Image, you just get one M1. Okay, now we have Namek Goku. First off, just like with Vegeta, remember I said basically any Dragon Ball character can do this. Just to prove it, I'm going to do it with Goku too. You can do 4 M1s, but attack cancel the 4th one to use a beam, so you don't have to ladder. See? It didn't block break the dummy, because you don't have to. You don't have to block break the dummy to M1 on the ground of Kamehameha. You just attack cancel with the 4th hit and Kamehameha will work without having the ladder. Another cool thing you can do with Namek Goku is down slam Kaioken and then use rush, and that's just a one shot combo with Kaioken. In Goku's base, you can make Spirit Bomb a combo extender if you ladder with it. Okay, first tip with Whitebeard. M1 range go Burt, so abuse this. Like, come on, bro. Second tip with Whitebeard. You can either attack cancel on your fourth hit with sweep to combo extend with it, or you can ladder with it. Either one works. That's combo extending by using attack cancel. And here's laddering with sweep. You can down slam with island shaking to make it so they can't jump over it. That's how you make it so they can't jump over it. All my tips for Yamamoto are actually in his awakening. So first off, you can ladder with torch. Like you see. And secondly, this is how you aim hell pillars. The first pillar will show up right next to your health bar on the left side. The second pillar will show up past that in a counterclockwise rotation. So you want to be about this far. Put the enemy on the corner of your screen, because the first pillar is going to hit right next, right here basically, if I'm aiming right here. Second one will hit here. So what this is going to do, it's going to block break him if he's blocking the first one, and then hit him the second one. Or if he's not blocking, it's just going to hit him twice. See? That's how you aim hell pillars. You aim it by putting the enemy on the side of your screen and being about this far away. Because the first pillar will always show up right here. We have now covered every single character in ABA. So this is the conclusion of the tips and tricks series. If you did enjoy that, try and get this video to 500 plus likes for it being the finale. And I hope you guys stick around. If you have any ideas for more videos that are like this that I can mix in with my ranked videos, then leave those down in the comments. If you have any tips that I left out of these videos, also leave that down in the comments so other people can know them as well. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching that. If you did enjoy, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You know, get your boy in the algorithm, know what I'm saying? But yeah, if you did enjoy that, don't forget to do those things directly supporting me. And I've got some other videos here if you want to watch them. But if not, have a good rest of your day, and I'll see y'all in the next one.